I don't know why the ring is not here. Never mind. Fuck. I'll just use my old strat and I'll just kill the NPC. And die to gravity. After all that trouble. Cack double. So then I'm gonna have to kill the NPC. Because that other guy aggroed. It's okay, I can come back there in less than 30 minutes. Thanks for the follow, Random. That scared me. The alert. So, is it Amy or Random? This should be the fastest attempt of the day. I think I forgot everything I can forget in the last two attempts, so this time I shouldn't forget anything. But now I know I have to kill that NPC for the ring. Maybe I could kick. Maybe I should try. If I kick that NPC, the dagger root, then maybe I can still make it. Maybe I can still make it without killing the NPC with the axe. But I don't want to test that right now. I want to get to the end game sometimes and not just play the beginning. Okay, this time I didn't forget anything. And I start running to Quelog at 11 minutes. So if I do everything perfectly, I can fight Quelaag at 17 minutes into the run. And probably kill Gargoyles at 27 minutes. And I think it's better to just stick with one choice. Either go straight to Quelaag without purple moss, or get the purple moss. If I try to get purple moss by killing two trees or three, and then decide to come here without purple moss anyway, then I will probably lose like 5 minutes. And this way I only spend 2 minutes. But I already feel much better doing these strats, because it's less stressful to reset. I can get back into the game much faster. Okay. I'm almost back at the spot where I died. It's not so bad. I forgot to pick up the bombs. But that's okay, because I can also use the time I'm there to pick up the ring as well. And then after gargles, I won't have to come back down here. Because after gargles, I would come back down here anyway. Because I want to pick up the ring of sacrifice. But now I can just pick up all of that before gargles. The only problem is if I die, then it's a waste of time, but maybe I don't die. Now, after I kill gargles, I don't have to go down. I can just run straight to Andre. And I will have the RTSR set up. Because I will need that now. This time I'm gonna kill the NPC with the axe. To get the flip ring. I don't use the bow because I want to keep the RTSR. And then I get the flip ring and I'm gonna go forward and try to beat this run. I'm gonna finally be out of this beginning part. Now I'm gonna see how much time I need to get the flip ring. But it's, I think it's 8 minutes. Or maybe I should try to push her off now. But I don't want to risk it anymore. I will just use my usual strats. They work. I had to concentrate a lot in this area. Because I really don't want to get hit. I'm really close to my distance PB. GG. Now I have to see. How much dex will I have? And also strength after I level up. I can't. I can't get 40 dex and 20 strength, but maybe I can get 19 strength with 40 dex. 19 is maybe enough. I know 20 is enough, but I don't know about 19. But if 20 is enough, maybe 19 is enough as well. Damn. Can't even get to 90. This can still work, but it's gonna be a little bit tougher. So I guess I need that one soul that I usually get, and this time I didn't get. That gives 10k souls, and also the giant gives 3k with my 5k. That's 18k. That's two upgrades. That would be 18. Strength, and by the time I finish on Orlando, it would be 19. And maybe 19 is enough. I forgot to switch the weapon, but it's fine. I had enough damage. Okay, I can have 18 strength with this strat. I don't think 18 strength will be enough. 19 maybe. But 18 probably not. But even if I can't kill Ornstein in 3 hits, I can still... I can still kill them without getting hit, but... it's gonna be harder. I'm pretty sure... well, I don't know, but I think I think 19 strength should be enough, so that's only 4 giants. If I killed 4 giants on the way, I could get 19. Okay, so next time, if 18 is not enough, I'll just kill some giants on the way. That was close. But I forgot. I forgot to upgrade the weapon. Now I just have to wait for the RTSR. I can easily get enough souls to upgrade to 19 strength if 19 strength is enough. But that's for the next round. Okay, I got him in 3 hits, but I'm not sure if that was because he took some extra damage or 3 regular hits is enough with 18 strength. I'm not sure. Have to calm my nerves a bit. GG. But now I'm not sure if 18 strength was enough to kill him in 3 hits, or I'll just watch the VOD later. Because sometimes boss can take some extra damage. So maybe he died in 3 hits because one of those hits were that extra damage, and that extra damage was right amount of damage that was needed to kill him in that 3rd hit. So I will have to watch the VOD later and make sure. If 18 strength is enough, then that's a good deal. But even if it's not 19 would probably be enough. And to get 19 strength, I don't need to go for that 10k, so I don't need to lose the extra time for that, so. I can just kill some giants on the way to 1S. Oh, fuck. Oh, never mind. I forgot that I have symbol now. I wanted to say I forgot to set up the RTSR on the elevator. But I forgot that I don't need the elevator anymore. I have a symbol. Got to wait for that RTSR again. GG. I don't think I got stagger, I didn't see. But I think I didn't. Now this next boss is, for me, it's really depending on RNG. If I don't get a hard landing and if he doesn't spawn the clone in some bad position for me. That was so close to the edge. Sometimes that skeleton from below can hit me if I stand close to the edge. While my character is recovering from the fall and I can't move, that skeleton can hit me. It happened once. But I fell so close to the edge that time. And somehow that skeleton managed to hit me from below. Brother below. GG. Okay, that's first part of the catacombs done. I have one more part. Running part and then boss. And then I'm done with this place. I have to go use the bathroom for a second and to calm down my nerves a bit. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. Ready to continue. Got to pick up that ring of fog. I hope I calmed my nerves enough. While I was on that tiny break. I feel like they calmed down a bit, but still. I can still feel it. I'm gonna really have to concentrate more and more. Okay, safely made it to the boss. Wait, I can even use... Oh yeah, I have some... I think I have extra gold pine. I got two on the way to Sif. But I used it too early. Never mind. I forgot about his walk, long walk. GG. I'm gonna go with extra endurance because I will have plus two crystal halberd. But then again, if I have too much endurance, I will maybe go for extra attacks where I shouldn't go for. No, he didn't attack. I always go for two attacks there. He never does that attack. Okay, so I will go for one attack from now on. Not a jump. Now I was lucky. I don't know why my character is jumping. Fuck. That was some dumb luck. That crystal soldier from behind me almost got me. But I guess sometimes I'm bound to have some luck as well, not only bad luck in this game. Constantly switching between being extremely nervous and being excited over the top. But either one of those can mess up with my gameplay. Being excited can get me shaky hands, and being nervous can do that as well. Hello. What happened there? I have 40 decks. I have 25 strength. My halberd is plus one, crystal halberd, and it didn't die in two hits somehow. Wait. What is the endurance here? Durability. It's okay. Something is weird. I feel like I'm doing some tiny bit less damage than usual. I don't know if that has anything to do with changing the class, I mean. It shouldn't. I'm not sure. Maybe this, but I don't know. Never thought about that. If different classes maybe have. But it should be only weapon based. Those, I don't know even how they're called. When some weapon has dexterity on C, strength on D, or it's all the same. Strength is D and dexterity is C. Stats are the same as warrior. Because I'm usually here with warrior. And today I decided to go with the faster strat for the early game. So I chose bandit class. But I don't think it's class based. I don't think that warrior does more damage. It's probably some weird RNG. I really have to concentrate right now. And double check everything before I commit to doing something. I'm always using slow strats here, so I'm not even gonna try to do something else. I'm not gonna even think about it. GG. Let's count the humanities. I have 5. That's 9. It's 21. And I didn't pick up the soul from the church on gargoyles. But that's easy to get. It's not even guarded. I think I have enough arrows. One ghost is 2 arrows. I don't know. If I have to kill, maybe 7 or 8 ghosts. So. Okay, I have more than enough. And even if I didn't have enough, I could go to Anorlando and buy it from the giant. But now I have to pick up the firekeeper soul from behind those ghosts at the end of that narrow pillar with my nervous, excited, shaky hands. But I could kill them. I don't know. I don't need to use the running strat. I could just kill him with arrows. But I think that's even more riskier because there are 3 of them going at me at the same time. And shooting arrows is too slow. Yeah, it's safer if you just run past them. It looks like it's not safer, but it actually is. GG. Now I can go to the boss. 14. Not 14, 16. I have a little devil in my mind or on my shoulder telling me to press the R1. I have to keep my finger away from R1. My muscle memory knows more than I know right now. I just reflexively enter the menu before I head off from that bonfire, and for a second I didn't know why did I turn on the menu. My muscle memory knows that I have to take off the slumbering ring now. Even though my mind forgot for a second. I guess it's a good thing that I died so many times and had to reset so many times. Because in all that time, my muscle memory had a chance to develop more and more. But now I have to rely on everything. That almost killed me. Removing the ring of fog there wasn't a good thing to do. Losing to the menu. And this time I'm gonna kill the demon. There is a small chance that it can hit you when you try to just punch him in the tail and run by his side. And that didn't happen to me for a long time. I think I passed him like 20 or 30 times. He never hit me, and then once it just happened. And because of that small chance, I'll have to kill him. With the save strats, of course. Oh yeah, I should use a running attack. Running attack is more damage. 150 damage more. I guess one more hit. My OCD tells me I have to put a ring of fog in this lot and slumbering in this one. I didn't do this boss for a long time. Something doesn't look right. Okay. This should be it. I was resetting so much in the early game that I didn't do this boss for a long time, and I also don't practice this boss because it was 100% so far. And I forgot the exact spot. But I guessed it right. Maybe I missed one chance, I didn't see. But I don't think so. The longer you stall boss, the calmer I am. You're just giving me time to relax my nerves. Finally. I'm not really sure if I missed chance or it really took him this long to do the attack. But GG anyway. I think I have enough arrows. One ghost, two ghosts, three ghosts, four ghosts. Yeah, I have more than enough. Now I'm excited. My mood is changing every minute or 2 minutes. I'm being nervous for a while. Then I stop being nervous and then I'm being overexcited. Then back to nervous, then back to excited. It's gonna mess something up probably in my gameplay. But maybe my muscle memory will save me. Or some luck. Or both. I got hit, I don't know, 3 or 4 times probably. Nah, even more. On this split. In the past runs. So I'll have to concentrate. Focus. One time I missed this ghost on the second shot and then he killed me. And I don't even know how many times I got hit while trying to run. Through that house part and I forgot about this now, but it's okay, they are falling back when I move back a little. the last time I got hit on these stairs. Because I was standing too close to the ghost. So I'm gonna stand back a little. Okay. I never know how to kill this ghost here, how to pull him. But I tried to kill him from the other side. I'm just gonna take my time and kill them now. I have transient curse. Oh shit, it expired. That should be all. I think so. And I can double check. They usually come here as well. Let's just set up the RTSR and equip the rings. Now the thing is, I never used Homeward Bones in King's Fight. Because when I was doing the PP runs, it didn't matter if I die once and go for another fight. And that means that I don't know when it's safe to cast Homeward Bone. Maybe I should relax a bit. Work. War Kings and Gwyn are my most practiced and most fought fights in this game. But anything can happen. Especially now. I'll just take my time a bit. To breathe. I don't even know if I... I got enough oxygen in the last... in the last 1 hour. But I also shouldn't think too much and just do the fights. Now this Wraith, or how it's called, it's gonna hit me. Card landing. Okay. I killed all the ghosts. Don't think too much. GG. Going to go in. Now I'll have to take some more time and relax. And calm down a bit. I guess I'll never be a speedrunner. But that's fine with me. I'm good with no-hit challenges. Nice. Let's look at the sky a bit. Take some time to relax. This is a very relaxing spot. I think this is the most peaceful spot you'll ever get in this game. But the damn Lotric, or how it's called, killed Firekeeper. Or she died somehow. If we had the campfire, it would be even greater mood. To sit by the fire, we even have a friend to talk with, share some stories, relax before going to the last boss. But the sky sure is pretty around here. And a little bit of fog and volumetric light. And the little happy clouds, happy little clouds, right? Happy little tree. And birdie. Man, I really have to relax and calm down. I can just sit here forever. Enjoy the view. Now this is a... Yo, hey, Noot. You're right in time. Thanks. I'm just taking my time here to relax. Life could be a dream. I need that monkey video. Life could be a dream, and I need that video about Happy Seal. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for the good luck. I also didn't do this part with the knights for a while. Because I always practice the Gwyn fight with save state. And they rarely go by this knight. Especially the last two ones before Gwyn. I was startled by my own footsteps. I had a slumbering ring, didn't hear myself walking. Then I took down the ring and mistaken my own steps with the knight behind me. Attack. I got him. Life could be dream. Life could be dream. GG. My first no-hit run. Thanks for watching, thanks for stopping by. Oof. Thanks for the GGs. I didn't even want to link anything when I was close to the finish because I knew I would just be more nervous. If more people showed up. But I tried to not think about that. Thanks for all the GGs. I didn't even want to link my stream on the promotion channels because I knew I'm getting closer and closer to getting the run. And I really didn't want to get more nervous than I have to. And my hands are now shaking. They didn't shake while I was playing, but now everything is. Everything is released at once. I didn't even expect I'm gonna get this so soon. I knew I could do it. I knew it for the past 2 weeks. That's why I didn't want to go for the new PB. And I was resetting my runs before ONS, if I get hit before ONS. But I never expected I would do it so soon. In less than a month since I started my baseline. And I can finally now install Dark Souls 2 and play it for the first time. Thanks, weekend note, for stopping by. You just made my day even better. And my dumbass best friend. That didn't want to do a movie marathon. I mean, we don't do movie marathons. We watch TV series. It was a great journey. I wouldn't even start this if Vicky didn't encourage me. I just wanted to finish the game deathless and then move on to DS2. But with few words of encouragement, I was inspired to just go for the no hit and forget about no death. And it was way more fun doing this. And I got no deaths with it anyway. Two birds with one stone. Thanks again for watching and supporting me from the beginning of the journey. And I'll just stop the stream now. So I make the video shorter for upload. Yeah, good night note. And everyone, I'm going offline as well. I'm gonna stop the stream and download the VOD and then upload to YouTube. And tomorrow I'll probably gonna link it to Team Hitless. Submit the run. It's gonna be a little pain in the ass for watching my run. It's 3 hours long. But I'm sure of it. I'm sure it's legit. I think I didn't get staggered anywhere. Okay, let's see if someone is streaming right now that I can rate. Of course not. Wait. I can, but I don't know if I can even raid their channel. I'm gonna raid Miko. He's doing Neo playthrough. Thanks for watching, everyone, and see you tomorrow. I mean, I'm not gonna stream tomorrow, but see you on your streams. thanks. Have a great evening, you as well, and night. And happy work tomorrow. Bye-bye.